This is absolutely mind-blowing. The entire world has been staring in absolute awe at images that have just been released from the James Webb Space Telescope, a $10 billion piece of equipment that traveled over 1.6 million kilometers to provide us with the sharpest and deepest glimpse into the cosmos, capturing light from over 13 billion years back into the history of our universe. And while there's been much admiration of the science and technology that has brought us these images, this is much more than just a photograph. As scientists are already pointing out themselves, this is a means towards further discovery and finding out answers to questions we still don't yet know.
We see examples of structures that, honestly, we don't even know what they are. Like, what's going on here?
And of all the questions that need to be answered, the most important question that needs to be addressed is, from where did all this come from? You see, as incredibly beautiful and mesmerizing this entire universe is, it still requires an explanation. The universe is adorned with galaxies and stars that are continuously expanding, changing, being born, dying, coming into and out of existence. In other words, the entire universe is filled with dependent and contingent beings that all require an explanation. I mean, if this universe is 13.7 billion years old, then there clearly was a time when none of it existed. So where did it all originally come from? And who or what is sustaining all these dependent things in the universe? These are questions that need to be addressed, yet they are questions that are outside the scope of science and beyond the realm of that which is observable and empirical. And this is nothing against science, for there are many things that science can't explain. I mean, science can't explain consciousness. It can't explain from where the first cell come from. It can't give an answer for why there is life instead of no life, or why there is something as opposed to nothing. Yet the universe still requires an explanation, and that explanation can only be from an independent source. Something that doesn't change, something that doesn't die, something that doesn't come into and out of existence, something that all dependent things rely upon, something that doesn't require any further explanation, because it is and always was an independent and eternal force, an everlasting creator. So while we can very well and rightfully so admire the science that brought us this image of this magnificent scene, let us not forget the one who gave us the scene to begin with. Allah. He is the one. And you can go ahead and dismiss my claims and criticize me for bringing religion or theology into this, but let us not forget that it was this religion, Islam, that brought us much of what we know about the stars today. Two-thirds of the stars in the sky with names have Arab names, a homage to the golden age of Islam. The father of modern optics, Ibn al-Haytham, who made way for the invention of the technology used in modern astronomy, was a Muslim. These are Muslims who were inspired by and driven by this book that constantly told them again and again and again to ponder over the universe and look into the sky for signs. A famous American astronomer once said,
in the words of the famous Carl Sagan, somewhere something incredible is waiting to be known.
And I have no doubt in that statement. In the entire universe and the creation of the heavens and the earth, there are signs of something incredible waiting to be known. And He is Allah.